Are you using SAP Integrated Business Planning? Or are you curious about what planning looks like using the Planner Workspace in SAP IBP? In this video, I will guide you through the usage of the Planner Workspace, and at the same time, I will also highlight some of the latest Planner Workspace improvements that come with the IBP 2305 release. Hi, my name is Jules Beckers, and I am a SAP Integrated Business Planning Consultant at McCoy & Partners. In this video, I'm going to show you the new features in the Planner Workspace app in SAP Integrated Business Planning. While working with clients at McCoy, we notice how difficult it can be to keep up with the latest updates regarding SAP IBP. Therefore, it is my pleasure to share with you some of the latest improvements in the SAP IBP 2305 release. As you might know, with every new release, many new features and improvements become available on IBP. In the latest release, 2305, for example, new machine learning capabilities have been added to the master data analysis application, and the way we use planner workbooks has been changed as well. For this video, we will focus on the changes that have been made to the planner workbooks. First off, let's take a look at the new setup for the Planner Workspace app. With the new release of SAP IBP, the planner workbooks are now integrated in a new area, and this area is called the Planner Workspace. Now we can make multiple workbooks in one single workspace area. This way, all workbooks within your organization are visible in one single area in the Voeren web app. With these workbooks, it is now possible to include different variants of the same workbook in the workspace, which are accessible through the new navigation menu. As a user, you can make different variants of a workbook by applying filters in the workbook and saving the workbook as a new variant, which makes navigation between different planning processes much easier. What is also new in the 2305 release of SAP IBP is that alerts are now accessible through the Planner Workspace. Another new addition is that now charts and planning views are visible in one view. With the Workspace filter, it is possible to filter the data across all of the displayed components of the workbook. In this video, I will show you that we can solve possible planning issues in the Planner Workspace using the Alert Overview. Furthermore, we will see the effect of the plan adjustments on our capacity utilization as well as on the total carbon footprint. This can all be done using one personalized overview. Now, let's have a look in IBP. For this video, we are going to look at a small network in SAP IBP. On the left, we see that multiple materials are being used to create finished goods in Beijing as well as in Frankfurt. In this example, both of these locations are able to create the same product, and our distribution center in Hong Kong is the recipient of this product. Let's take a look at the Planner Workspace for this network. Now we are in the Voeren web app of SAP IBP. We choose the Planner Workspace style and we navigate to our own personalized Planner Workspace. In the navigation menu, you can see the workbooks that are in your personal planner workspace. If you select a workbook and need to use the full screen to see the planning components, you can hide the navigation menu by double-clicking on the splitter. At the top of every workbook, you can see the filters that are applied to the specific workbook variant, and like before, you can interact with the analytics charts in the workbook. In this case, we can see a customer demand from two of our customers in Hong Kong. We see that the consensus demand for customer number one is stable at 500 products per week. And that for our second customer, the consensus demand is showing a peak in calendar week 25. We can also view workbooks from different planning processes. Here I can, for example, look through the shipments from our DC towards our customers. In this next view, I can look at information about our capacity usage at our two different production locations. In IBP, it is also possible to include components like CO2 footprint analysis. In this example, we see that our carbon footprint is higher when we decide to ship our product to Hong Kong from Frankfurt instead of Beijing. So, overall, in this workspace, we have combined planner workbooks for the customer demand through the different weeks, the amount of products that are going from our distribution center towards the customer, capacity utilization at our production plants, the CO2 footprint that results from our activities, and finally our location sourcing ratio, which I will attend to later in this video. What's also new for the planner workspace is that now we have an improved overview of alerts that are relevant for a planner. These alerts can be very useful to solve planning issues quickly and without having to look at too many irrelevant details, but focus only on the part of the planning that needs the attention from the planner. Let's have a look. When you have navigated to the workspace, in the same navigation menu, we can now directly look at the alerts that we set. Here we see the overview of our alerts. At the first level, we can see the alert subscriptions and the number of alerts that are active within each section. After selecting an alert subscription, you can see the alert details. In this example, we see that two different kinds of alerts have been defined. One alert is giving us a warning that some of the resources are reaching a relatively high utilization in our current plan and almost reached the maximum capacity. The other alert is telling us that we have one resource that has exceeded our maximum capacity utilization at one of our production locations. I will now demonstrate how we can easily dive into the problem and solve the alert by making an adjustment. When you open an alert, the relevant components related to the alert will automatically appear. In this alert, we can see that the maximum capacity utilization has been exceeded by around 14%. In this example, we are manufacturing the products for our customer in Hong Kong, mainly in Beijing. But we can, however, produce the same product in Frankfurt as well. To show you the behavior of the alerts in the planner workspace, we will now solve this problem. First, we will create a new scenario in which we will try to solve our problem. To do this, we can click on Scenarios, then Create Scenario. Now we want a new scenario on the base version, and we will call this scenario Capacity Issue Solved. Within this new scenario, we will now change the sourcing ratios in the Location Sourcing Workbook, which can now be done directly in the same planner workspace view that is shown when we open the alert. The sourcing for this product was set to be completely on the Beijing production facility due to its preferred location. Because we have exceeded the capacity at our Beijing plant, we need to source some of the products at our location in Germany. Now we have changed the location sourcing, we can run an application job within the planner workspace. For this demonstration, I will run an unconstrained heuristic on the scenario that we just created. After the application job has completed, we can see if this solved our problem. As we can see, after refreshing the data, the alert is no longer there. Next to the capacity utilization, let's check the effects of our changes on the CO2 emissions in the planner workspace. A geographic map shows the total emissions of our finished products for a supply plan. This chart allows you to drill down to a more detailed level of information. This way, you can analyze which products are responsible for the largest share of the overall emissions. Since we were already exceeding the maximum capacity in Beijing, we had to produce in Frankfurt, which would mean a higher footprint. In this case, we can compare our base scenario with the one that we have just created. To do this, we can simply add it to our scenario selection in the workbook. Because we had to source some of the products in Frankfurt, we can now see an increase in our CO2 footprint related to the production. So, to summarize, we had a capacity issue at Beijing, and we have decided to source some of the product from our second production facility. With the planner workspace, we were able to monitor the effect this had on our ecological footprint. Now that we solved the capacity issue, all that is left to do is to promote this new scenario to become the new base scenario. To do that, we will go to Manage Scenarios, select the scenario in which we solved the issue, and promote it to become the base scenario. This is just one use case. You can also use this approach for other addressing cases in IBP, such as calculating the costs of your transportation activities or your total ecological footprint. With such a model, you can, for example, plan your ecological footprint for each of your products aligned with your planned transportation activities with a targeted emission cap for CO2. I hope this video has helped to give you an idea of the functionality of the new planner workspace. If you would like to learn more about SAP IBP, then please check out our other videos about SAP IBP or subscribe to our channel to receive regular updates on new developments.